Here are the 10 reasons why people fail in AWS exams and how you can avoid it. These reasons are based on the personal experiences of people around me and the precautions which we took to ensure that we pass AWS certifications. So here we go. Reason number 1. Few number of practice tests attempted. Many people don't know how prepared they are because they practice less and they only trust their instincts and not results. Now of course, there is no hard and fast rule that these many number of practice tests are required to pass AWS exam. But at least trying to score 70 to 75% and at least attempting 4 to 5 practice tests having good difficulty level will actually give you some self-confidence that you are prepared for AWS exam. In case you are interested to know which practice tests and courses I recommend for some AWS certifications, then check the description below. Reason number 2. Relying too much on dumps. Now these people rely too much on dumps and not on the actual concepts, and then they get surprises on the day of exam. There are tons of dumps available on internet that claim to be similar or matching to actual AWS exam questions. But I don't think any of them matches the actual AWS exam questions. I mean, it's too risky to rely on them and trust them, right? Instead, the best way is to complete the AWS course which you have taken and practice as much as you can with good quality practice tests with good reviews available on net. Of course, the questions in those practice tests won't match the one in actual exam, but they can really give you the good sense of actual exam difficulty and the areas in which you might go wrong. Reason number 3. No proper time management in actual exam. Now these people couldn't attempt all questions even if they know answers and they fell short of time. Look, many of us don't take time management seriously, but prevention is better than cure, right? You know the number of questions expected in exam, you know the time limit given. So just plan for your time in exam properly and set aside some buffer 10 minutes. And as per my experience, there is more time crunch in actual exam than the practice test, especially for specialty and professional level exams. So just plan for your time beforehand. Reason number 4. Changing too many answers when exam is about to end. So for these people, when the exam is about to end, many answers seem to look incorrect for them and then they end up changing half of the answers, which is risky and many of them might go wrong. See, the four choices provided for each question can look very similar to each other and correct answers can be chosen with proper thought and thinking. Also, at the end of exam, while reviewing the answers, it is okay to change some answers for some questions. But I really recommend not changing too many answers, say 25 to 30 answers out of 65, as you might make mistake in hurry, right? Now obviously this is subjective and varies from person to person and situation and their preparation levels, but do consider staying firm to most of your answers while exam is about to end. Now the next reason is funny one. Reason number 5. Skipped meals and nature's call. AWS exams are lengthy and they require your high level of attention and thinking process. You can really feel hungry during those 2 to 3 hours or may feel urged to hear your nature's call, that is washroom break. This is really distracting and annoying and may affect your performance. So better have a good meal and avoid drinking excess water before exam. And before we move ahead, I would like to tell you that if you are really liking the content of this video, help me by subscribing to this channel so that I can make more such videos for you all. Reason number 6. Hardly revising what they studied. People tend to forget things if they haven't revised important concepts. Now this differs from person to person, but it is a very good practice to revise what you have learned in courses, FAQs and white papers. So at least revise what you have studied so far once or twice. Reason number 7. Appearing for exam even if not prepared or overconfidence. These people, even if scoring less in practice tests or not completing their course, they will appear for AWS exam. Some might even say, I'm not able to cross 50% in practice tests. Who cares? I know I'm going to pass. So few lucky of them manage to pass the exam, but many don't. So check whether you are actually scoring good in practice tests and have gone through all the concepts required for exam if you want to avoid such problems going ahead. You have an option to reschedule your exam if you are not prepared. But don't rely on luck. Just reschedule your exam if you feel you are not prepared, or just study more, but just don't assume things. Reason number 8. Low consistency in preparation. Now these kind of people, they study first module some months ago, then they will study today, then they will study the next chapter on module 3 to 4 months later. So they fill in so many time gaps in between that they are not able to recollect things and they cannot join dots. Now it's totally understood that your job role might not allow you with enough time to continuously prepare. But the key idea here is to at least stay in touch or keep revising what you have studied so far. Or at least try to stay consistent with what you have studied or what you are studying now. Delaying the process and having gaps in between can make you lose confidence and get to do rework of studying or starting all over again. Reason number 9. No proper planning or strategy for study. Some people might directly study advanced concepts before learning basics, or some even give practice tests before actually learning some concepts. These will increase your confusion and you might not get an idea of how much you are prepared. So take baby steps, plan your strategy beforehand, and conquer the modules and tests one by one. Reason number 10. Too afraid or panic to appear for exam. And this one is the last reason in this video. If you are really panicked, it will hamper your ability to think properly and arrive at correct solution. There are people who get so afraid during the exam that they cannot arrive at one answer firmly, and they just think and they are not able to think, and then they go blank and then boom, they forgot things. So trust me, the AWS certification exam are not too difficult to crack, yaar. Come on, you can certainly pass if you are well prepared. So listen, fear comes with uncertainty. The more you practice and revise concepts, the more you will build confidence and the better you will perform in actual exam. So practice and practice and practice more and your fear will start to disappear. So these were the 10 reasons why people fail in their AWS exam. If I have missed any reason or if you have experienced any of such situations, let me know in the comments section below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel and press that like button and press the bell icon. Thank you so much for watching and all the best for your AWS journey.